Welcome back to Politics Watch, this is Sir P. Today I'm going to talk about someone who the Don for Stonecrusher used to tell people was his Don. Who am I talking about? Robert Harding, aka Babu. A man whose life has been a mystery for many. Only people who really come from certain parts of St. James know about him. If you try to Google him, you won't find much. A few articles there and there, no pictures, right? Matter of fact, the picture that you're about to see soon, this is the first time enough people are gonna know what him look like. See, I know it's been a while since me cover the Stonecrusher organization. People could later say, no, it look like Sir P run out of file on Stonecrusher. No, still have the file him stack up, have them in my cabinet listed in alphabetical order. But you see, Babu, the reason why now is the ideal time to talk about Babu is because, one, Moby hot again, right? Remember last year it was being put out there that see, Moby had toned down, the numbers are showing that Moby, the crime is going down. Let me tell you something about Moby. Just like Rima, just like Dunkirk, just like West Kingston, just like Jungle, just like Augustown. Anytime when you see a certain place cool, if you have 6 months, even a year, don't get caught up in the hype. That's just what you call a lull in the battle. See, sometimes when you're on the battlefield, you might be engaged in a shootout that lasts 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 hours, might last the whole day. But in between all of this, you get some periods where complete quiet, complete calm, no shot, no fire. That's called a lull in the battle. This is a good time to get some water, eat a quick snack, get some calories in your body, right? Rally your troops. But at no point should you think the war is done, the battle is over. It's just a lull. It will get hot again. That's how Moby and them place they run. So when you hear stories about Norwood and them place, the triple shooting and double murder and all these things, you have to understand the war just get hot again. It was just a lull. It was a deception. There was no peace. What do you think? Crime plan did that work? It is 87s who decide when them get hot and when them get cool. Know that. But if you understand how Moby around now, you have to go back in time. Babu, Robert Harding, his legacy lives on to this day. See, Babu played a very important role in the deadly Stonecrusher gang. He might not be as infamous as the more known members, right? You know, people like Bigger Crime, Cedric Doggy Murray, or even Eldon Calvert. These names come in the news more often, right? More Jamaicans probably heard about them. Even if they know them look like, they would have heard the name a few times. And of course, my longtime listeners, them would know about Rowan Garden, aka Sir D. Right, the Don for Stonecrusher. But Babu, why nobody really know about Babu outside of Moby like that? Even though he was so powerful and influential. Well, the short answer is because most of the time he did a foreign. See, Babu, he was running around with the crew from even the Renegades days. Because remember, it was Renegades before them kind of offshoot into Stonecrushers. But Babu did end up get a bus and got fine. But before that happened, he almost lost his life. See, Babu did get shot up by some youth from the Ravers gang, right? And even after peace treaty signed, whole by intervention, man agreed, say, alright, shooting a go stop, war a go done. Babu was not having it. He disregarded the fake peace treaty where them did have, because them peace treaty then a badness. 9 times out of 10 them fake. Right. Them don't really mean nothing. Man signed peace treaty Monday and Tuesday gonna shoot at back place again. So anyway, Babu run down upon the same ravers man them, right? Shut up some of them and had his revenge. You see, Babu, before him got foreign, when he was in his younger days, Babu was responsible for a gun. Where the renegade man them called it, scared him. It was a 12 gauge shotty. As you can imagine, the sound made it make. That's how it got the name, scared him. Right? Babu also had links where him could have get the shot them. So he was very influential and connected. Plus when you add to the fact that Babu had ties to a farmer down, right, called Hangman Trees. Right, now we go way back in time now. But Hangman Trees was also a Don. And because of theme ratings, when people find out say him and Babu had ties, right, that kind of automatically pass over to Babu because of them thing they go. When people find out say you are linked with certain man, or if you are the brother of the Don, you are the cousin of the Don, that kind of automatically fall upon you. Right? Sometimes all you have to be is a friend of the Don. Right. Just show some kind of connection, right, and certain doors will open for you. Couple that with the fact that Babu was also willing to put himself out there, take certain risk. No father 87, no father man in the criminal network, they love him and rate him. Right. So doors did open for Babu. So he was always influential, even before him got foreign. But when him got foreign, him really get powerful. Because no matter how bad you want to be, in crime, you need money. And Babu had lots of it. Now you know what come next. You know him start by next and send go back to Jamaica next. Yes, gun pan gun pan gun. Babu started for arm the youths them, right, him left behind in a Jamaica. I mean, some of them did have gun, right, but at the time, and everybody could have get one. By the time Babu done buy gun and send gun to Jamaica, Stone Crusher, which was now on the rise, quickly became one of the most heavily armed organizations in St. James. That was one of the reasons why they could outshoot none of their rivals. Right, them did have gun for that way. Remember the strength of an organization, the strength of a gang in Jamaica is really built around how much firepower them have. Because the 87s can easily be replaced. There's always some new ones on the conveyor belt. Right. So the access to guns the Stone Crusher they have, they give them an advantage. Right. No flicker organization who used to could have compete with them back in the day. Right. Who used to give the renegades a little problem. Because remember there was a time when them used to call renegades man them runegades. Right. Ravers man them used to diss them and call them runegades and say all them do run up and down. But renegades got stronger. By the time them are shooting to Stone Crusher, them carried even further. No, they had the 87s, they had the guns, they had the links. Perfect recipe for disaster. See, Babu was not just sending back guns, because you know, badness is a lifestyle in Jamaica. He did not send back some of the toughest jewelry, some of the gold chain them where you might catch Sir D and bigger crime them in a. Nobody never see them in them life. This increased Babu's ratings, not just amongst the 87s, but against the ordinary people in the community. Right. Enough people looked up to him. Because unfortunately, in certain communities, when a young youth I try to look for a symbol of success, the only people them surround them having that success are criminals. And this enticed them to be one themselves. So you might hear me say Babu was influential in Stone Crusher. But you might be wondering just how influential. Well, here's a simple test. I'm going to tell you the names of some of the most dangerous members of the gangs. And these people would tell the people them closest to them, so only one man can call them and tell them say, for spear somebody who they might go for. For example, bigger crime. Once bigger crime set somebody as a target, it was difficult for the rest of the members of the Stone Crusher pulling back. Sir D, who was the Don for Stone Crusher, who was the leader at the time, who was bigger than bigger crime in terms of rank, still used to have problems keeping bigger crime's lust for blood under control, because they would agree before them go upon some operation that them people are not involved, we don't want them people here, so just leave them alone. We only want person X and person Y. And bigger crime would agree, and as soon as them go upon the ops, when him reach, him kill everybody. However, when Babu tell him say, don't trouble us, Malady, he would leave them alone. That's how powerful he was. Bigger crime, listen to it. So Sir D, who was the Don, used to tell people say, him only have one Don, and that's Babu. Bigger crime, right, the maniac, who only respected and take talk from very few people, Babu was one of them. But he was another 87. We know if you're in Jamaica, not going to really instantly recognize this name, but maybe people him are going to open. The name of that 87 was Trevor. Very, very dangerous youth. He's going to get his own video, but don't worry about it. It will come in time. Trevor is right up there with some of the most brutal youths in the Stone Crusher organization. But I'm telling you, sir, that youth was feared, and he was also a gang leader in his own right. As a matter of fact, there is an infamous story. One of your favorite entertainers was supposed to turn up to a stage show in a Glendevon and never turn up. And Trevor make it known, say, he might go for him and shot him in the head. And he was serious. Remember, Stone Crusher at the time, the business about nobody. Whether you want to be entertainer, whether you want to be celebrity, from you cross them, then they'll go for you. This was a gang that was shooting police at will. So them never business about no celebrity. And them never care about no excuse as to why the artist couldn't turn up. But when we do the Trevor video, you're going to hear all about that. But to cut a long story short, it was Babu who called Trevor and tell Trevor say to spare the life of that artist. I'm just trying to show you how powerful he was. The most dangerous 87s, the most dangerous members of the Stone Crusher gang, who people believe say nobody can reel them in, nobody can stop them once them head get hot, Babu could stop them. He could tell them leave it alone. That's how powerful this man was, and Jamaica don't know about him. Most people in Jamaica don't know about him. All through the reign of Stone Crusher, when people are calling the name of certain members, theme name never get called yet. In that foreign. And as them say, out of sight, out of mind. Now, Babu had his beloved Kerosene. A girl who him used to watch so hard that nobody couldn't go nowhere near her. A matter of fact, when word get back to Babu, same Kerosene of next man. You know what Babu do? Babu send the Stone Crusher man them for burn down the man house. He didn't stop there. Him even start send the Stone Crusher man them to intimidate the family members of the man. Remember at the time, all Babu have to do is send the word. Anybody Babu send the Stone Crusher man them for, them a go. Even if them know you, even if you and them are friend, once Babu send the words to go for him, do that to him, it a go happen. That's how powerful he was. Even though him live a foreign, he was still having problems with other mobile man who are foreign at the same place as him. And as soon as them fall out, he may send the word to the Stone Crusher man them for go for them relatives in a mobile. Just like that. Or if a man a foreign diss him, and then him hear say the man fly down, when that person fly down, they would get a very, very rude surprise after them get a visit from the Stone Crusher gang. This only helped to strengthen his name, because now enough man start to realize, even though them can probably diss him a foreign, or you know, put up local resistance a foreign on Jamaican soil, with the Stone Crusher gang there, a gang that was willing to go almost anywhere in Jamaica for anybody, enough people I realize, you know what? It wasn't worth crossing Babu. not many people were willing to run them risk there. Not when you have people like Sir D, Bigger Crime, Trevor, and them and they who were willing to go for anybody once Babu send the word. All this was happening, Buddy had dropped a Jamaica like fly, and people had asked the question, why is so much money dead? Then what him do? Enough people don't even know. Say sometime, the person don't actually do nothing. Sometime of them relative are foreign, and Babu in a problem, and Babu just say, you know what, get rid of him. And so said, so done. Now earlier I mentioned that Stone Crusher did not hesitate to kill police officers. As a matter of fact, there was even a list found on one of the members, right, of some names of people who Stone Crusher was supposed to kill, and none of them were police officers. See, even though it was easy for Babu and the Stone Crusher man them to bribe some police officers, there were others who did not want their money. And this would lead to all kind of problems. You would have wanted a police in Amobi who were dedicated to the destruction of Stone Crusher. And you'd have a next set of police who were aiding and abetting them, who were tipping them off about raids. So one set of police had planned big operations to capture Stone Crusher man, right? And then them owner squaddy would tip off the man them, say, yo, them are come tomorrow, right? Them are going over here, so, right? Don't drive away there, go over the way there. Some of them would provide Stone Crusher man them with police uniform. Oh yes, one of Bigger Crime and Sir D's favorite tactics is to dress up in a full police uniform from head to toe. Every single thing. And because obviously them have them own an M16 rifle. So when them done dress up in them outfit, them look like the real deal. This was one of their most destructive strategy, because when them pull up in our community and them come out of a vehicle, if a 4 or 5 of them, everybody in a full police uniform. I'm talking even the vest. This was being supplied to them by crooked police officers. Now for them, you see claims, oh, we lost this, we lost that, we can't find this, we can't find that, when time of them I sell it and I supply it to the Stone Crusher man them. Bigger Crime, Sir D, they were so brazen. They used to set up checkpoints and stop and search vehicle looking for their enemies dressed up as police. Let me say that again. There was a time in Mobi when gang members, criminals, used to dress up in a full police uniform of checkpoints. And when they go through checkpoints under SOE, Sir D them used to have them own checkpoint. But Kiara drive up and a stop, and them are looking at them, are telling before wine on them window. They were looking for their enemies. When me telling you say Mobi is a Hollywood movie, Mobi has its own Netflix series, you have to understand why me say that. Because only in a movie, citizens would drive up to a checkpoint and a wind down window and a answer question, thinking say police them I talk to, not knowing say it's the Stone Crusher gang. These uniforms would also allow them to knock upon people door. People would come out, oh, good night officer, thinking it's a normal police. When time them look, a gunman, Sir D them, Bigger Crime them, Trevor them, push past them, gun at them, most can't kill them family. So the police force was now having an internal battle between the officers who were doing actual crime fighting and the officers who had tried to feed them wanga goat. Right? And then, if them realized that a policeman was encroaching upon them, right, and was getting too close to exposing them, or a policeman was reporting them to him seen as, and I say, you know what, I think Constable so-and-so I work with Stone Crusher now. Then the same police them would then tip off Stone Crusher and help set up them squaddy for Stone Crusher kill them. Only if people realize how serious Jamaica is. Enough policemen lose them life because they were actually doing crime fighting. You know, real crime fighting. Not the fake Mickey Mouse put on a show. But policemen in Ula pressure, Stone Crusher too much. Them just link one of them Hungry Belly squaddy and ask them where him live, what kind of car him drive, which route him normally take, Oh, alright, I could trail him and kill him. This was happening in real life. Police are helped set up police because police are cause problems for criminals. Something can go so. Luckily, there were some members of the security forces who were resolute. No matter how much danger they were in, no matter how much stress them did I get, no matter how much they warned them I get, if you turn the other cheek, if you look the other way, they would not. That's why, even though we have to call out the crooked elements in the JCF, we also have to come in, demand them who really, really take them job seriously, because at the time, to go against Stone Crusher was often a death sentence. Now for the policeman, them who stay upon a certain case, right, who they plan certain operations, who were told what gonna happen to them family if they no back down, and them still keep pushing. Now for those men are unsung heroes. Nobody would ever know them name, cause them not famous like the policeman them where, you know, Jamaicans love glorify. But them man, they were at it, toe to toe, against some of the sickest criminals Jamaica has ever seen. That is why you hear me say, when it comes on to destroying gangs in Jamaica, it's either them can do it or them don't want to do it. Because as big and powerful as Babu was, as feared as Stone Crusher was, soon as them got to the point where they got too big for their bridges, they were being cut down one by one. Remember, it got to a point where Stone Crusher, in them prime, did even start to affect tourism. Stone Crusher did start to affect the Golden Goose. And of course, you know, can't allow that to happen. So, one by one, them start drop. But the boy never really surprised when people like Trevor, right, that bigger crime and them and the Sir D and them and the start get take out. The real surprise came when Babu was targeted. But you're probably wondering, but Babu would live a fine. Oh, he may not get catch. Well, Babu got deported. Babu, from a simple incident, ended up reach back to Jamaica. You want to know the incident? He was traveling with a little bit in the back of him car firing. And the baby wasn't in a proper child seat with no seat belt. And from that, question start ask. So run, file go run, and just like that. Them go say, hold on, you? Uncle Sam say, you? Come on, go up on a plane, straight back to Jamaica, you go. And after being safe and sound and foreign, all those years, Babu was back in Jamaica. But more on everything about this. Jamaican authorities didn't know about Babu, you know. But at no point, them never yet send an extradition request for him. Them never yet send no paper say, yo, Uncle Sam send this man come to Jamaica. Uncle Sam have a book up in him, right? And then go run file and realize, say, well, you're not straight. Go back to Jamaica, man. You don't find it strange. Say, any Dan can just sit on a foreign and run place and not care how much murder attached to them name. Jamaica no send for them. Wouldn't find that strange. Jamaica have an extradition treaty with America and it worked both ways. The same way America can send for man, Jamaica can send for man too. Wouldn't find it strange to say one favorite politician not send for nobody. Wouldn't find that strange. When we hear the name of the man, them were send go and come get this and run off over your son and fund them gang, wouldn't find it strange. So no kind of treaty, no extradition request now sent for them. You think Uncle Sam would each be sending them back? You think if the Jamaican government can present a case and say, listen, that man here is a violent producer, he might do this, he might do that. Send him back. You think Uncle Sam would say, no, we're not sending him. We're going to protect his rights. And you think Uncle Sam would drag it out like how those things drag out? Uncle Sam would be like, good riddance. Hurry up and take him. Uncle Sam would put him on a private plane. Hurry up and take him. Your favorite leaders don't want to send the extradition papers. When I tell them, say, either they can do it, or they don't want to do it. I would know, say, they can do it. So that means they don't want to do it. So, After bad luck reach Babu or bad blessing, depending on how you want to look on it, drop back at Jamaica, and within 3 weeks, Babu was dead. Police killed Babu. Must me tell you that enough police did have up Babu. Them did know sir him that foreign. I control this and I control it. I send this and I send that. No, for the death and destruction while raining upon Moby a few orders them did a cause it. So enough man did a set for Babu. Then couldn't wait for him come back. He may reach back long time if you know your favorite politicians and they send for him. Remember, a policeman in a station, no matter how good his intention is, him can't pick up no paperwork and say nothing to America. He need bigger heads to deal with it. So the bigger heads them responsible for this. And the bigger heads them to send for Babu long time. Anyway, guess where Babu spent his final minutes? Guess where Babu lost his life? In a bathroom. In a bathroom. Babu met his demise upon him toilet seat. The man who was the big boss, that friend make much money, have much talk, took his final breath upon him bathroom gong after him dropped on it. Now, would you believe me if me tell you say there were protests for Babu? Would you believe me tell you say residents were protesting that the police them kill an innocent man? Babu no do nobody nothing. Would you believe me? Look at your screen right now. The people them protest and say Babu no do nobody nothing. The police them just go kill him. I murder them, murder him off. No do nobody nothing. Him just come back in that place. Him not get no trouble. Then time the Babu that foreign sending much gun and sending much orders, much house get burned down, much man get killed, much people get beaten and broke up. From the phone calls them even make. And the residents them know that too. But I'm telling you already, in a bad man place, 6-year-old and 10-year-old and 81-year-old don't get protest. Right. When them people are dead at the hands of criminals, silence. But police kill somebody like Babu and you get your protest. More people from Jamaica, if you understand. When in the US, they go and catch a wharf and all these things, and you know, police no follow up, nothing, police no do no sting operation. When you need to know, so there are police officers who warn them things, yeah. You have serious police not the force, you know. We see people them who can make the call, them not make the call. The people them who can set up the sting operation, nah, set up the sting operation. You think a chance, you think a coincidence that in Jamaica's entire existence, may I talk from 62, there has been not one operation where not just catch gunna wharf, but apprehend the people them who send, receive, and bring down the entire network behind it. You know, find it strange that there's never been a single one in history? Never? All the police in Jamaica glorify and say, the man are bad man police and the man have to go run this and take over that. None of them can come up with an operation. We not just catch the gun them off. That's the first part. Probably the easiest part too. But then apprehend, not just the look up. Kerosene where I come pick it up, right? But the man them who let go buy it, the man them who send it off, the man them who hide this and hide that and bring down the entire network, not once. You don't find that strange? You see, Jamaica need first to have the serious leaders or give the go ahead and say do that. Then they need the police them with a hand clean enough to go do it. JCF is locked in a battle. Locked in a battle between police officers who genuinely want to see Jamaica better, are true crime fighters, 87 now by them all, and from the other side you have the crooked Wanga Gut police officers who are willing to go as far as to set up their own squaddy so that them can continue to eat our food. The question is, which side are going to win? I wonder if people realize that there are police officers who have left the force and run away from Jamaica because they got to a point where they were threatening to mash up certain criminal organizations. And one time, them think say, by reporting to certain bigger policemen who will help them finish off these criminal organizations, they can find out that the policeman who they might report to or work with the criminal organization. JCF need to clean house. The security forces on a whole need to clean house. The residents of these communities need to clean house. Jamaica needs to clean house. You have to understand, the eat our food by any means attitude is not exclusive to the security forces or even politicians or whoever. It's a Jamaican attitude. As long as somebody can't give me a thing, I will turn that blind eye to an entire barrel full of gun. No one said them barrel are going in a certain community that is already struggling to deal with the guns that they have already. But on top of it, they might get the next 100. But as long as get to eat our food, I don't see nothing. I mean, I hear nothing. That kind of attitude, that's a Jamaican attitude. That right there is culture. People who can say, you know what? Even though I love to make extra money, the fact that I'm going to need more death and destruction on my people, in my communities, I don't depend on that. It's going to start to have more of them people, when I go see Jamaica better. But until then, be prepared for your 2, 3, 4, 5 a day. 6-year-old, 10-year-old, 81-year-old, 5-year-old, baby pump breast, in the matter. People are going to drop like fly. And be prepared if you see your favorite kerosene get woke when the murder turn up on them doorstep. Be prepared if you see your favorite tough talking, leave bad man alone, chat too much. Right. Fake wannabe thug. Look out for see him on your IG page. A ball say somebody shot him granny. If nobody know who, you think you can call the police, because that's the attitude in Jamaica. The same man I tell us, anybody who give police information for dead, call them an informer. When female mother get shot in her face, you see him on your IG. Nobody know the information, can please call this number. And but you say informer for dead. You say people who talk to police for dead, and who people give police information for dead. So why if you give police information now? Cause of your mother? Cause of your pitney? That's strange. Or you woke all of a sudden? Yeah, we don't believe you. So just look over social media more and more. You ever see people in 2021 bawling and begging for help for them family who just come face to face with the ugly monster known as crime? People who normally love the acidity, love the death and destruction, consume it, right, get thrilled by it. When them see the real face of it, then tell them and tell them, say, we need to change. We need to stop. We need to, why we can't manage it? Well, guess what, Mr. Overnight Activist and Miss Kerosene? When you're spending your whole life on social media trying to convince people, say, a good man then on here, everybody innocent. Right. When one of them innocent man they turn the gun upon you or somebody you care about, keep saying the same thing. Keep saying them innocent. Because in a Jamaica, there's no gunman. There's never been a gunman in Jamaican history. One of them innocent. All innocent. Anyway, I'm going to leave this one and stuff for now. Moby, I'm going to forget about it now. But because bed bugs are giving themselves so much problem, right? That's your uncle, Richie. I give himself so much problem. Been focusing on the cans a lot lately. If you remember at the end of the day, I'm only one man. So, sometime, if we shine light over here, so then shine light over here, so we don't forget nobody. Even if it appears, say, oh, Sir P, stop talking about now. My things, everything alright and everything forgotten, but next thing you know, like Nicodemus in the night, here I come. Patreon squad, big up on yourself. PIA, you don't know. More life. Ultra squad, stay circling. On a long video like this, there's bound to be some scraps tonight somewhere. And as grotesque as they are, even vultures deserve to eat. Bless.